Have you ever wondered what the bottom of an ocean looks like? Well, now you really don't have to know. Wait, what? Have you ever wondered what the bottom of the ocean looks like? Well, now you really don't have to wonder, because I found it. I sort of found my second wind, and I think it's going to carry me all the way through the rest of this side. Hopefully, the whole thing's done by the next video. One thing that is actually helping a lot is I cut down on my shifting. I was shifting a little too much, being way too shifty before. So now, instead, for breaking the blocks, when I'm on top of them, I just do kind of this sort of thing where I break two, back up, break two, back up. Oops. You know, that's actually a really accurate simulation of what happens. Other than that, there's not really that much to report. You know, besides just, you know, updating, down dating, carbon dating. Now, since I foresaw this happening, where I was going to just be doing this a bunch and not having much to talk about it because I already talked a bunch about it, I went back to the town, which is always a great spot to go back to. I must say that I'm pretty darn happy with how this town's turned out so far. Might not be entirely done, but, you know, I'm pretty happy. Let's see. There's the big guy up there looming over me shoulder, behind my head. I also haven't seen my character in a while without its armor, so that's a real treat for me. However, there is a spot that I have neglected. And, you know, this path, it's lovely. You know, I took the time to decorate it all the way up to the clock tower there. But here, I kind of stopped. And there's my old house. This way leads to the mines, which that's usually how I get in. But if I want to go to the upper part of this mountain, I end up going up this thing. This kind of stairway, whatever. And at the top, I just kind of run that way, you know, indiscriminately. Or discriminately, you know. I probably know what I'm doing more than I think. But I go past this mine entrance, which is kind of, you know, one of those watch your step. You know, keep your eyes on the ground when you're walking around here. I don't want to fall all the way. But anyway, I would like to extend the trail up here in a more natural looking and interesting way. And I want to have some sort of like a kind of an abandoned, like start a road of ruins, kind of like a pathway that leads, you know, winding around into where the castle is, and then along the way there'll be like hints of the older civilization that was here. And I want to start with this. I'm not sure if this mine is still going to be used by the village. It's debatable, but I know that the buildings here must have been here for a while. So I'm going to go with that. I'm going to go with the fact that maybe they're a little dilapidated. Maybe they barely exist. I think I'm going to carve out some mountain over here. So I'm going to do that to give a little pocket to kind of have stuff nestled in here. You know, be all cute and stuff. After that, I think I'm going to make a tunnel that just goes straight through here and comes out near where the water starts. Thank you. Let's get a nice aerial view here. So this is kind of what I got. I pushed everything back as naturally as I could, and I was actually going to take out this whole shelf, but I kind of like this being sunken in a little bit back here. I guess if I want to fine-tune it at all, I totally can. I sort of left this wall flat, so that could probably be the like where a tunnel probably comes out and joins in down there with the lower area. So I think I'll do that next. Okay, I finished. And this worked out really well. Actually, it worked out perfectly. A little too perfectly, if you know what I mean. You know, it's just going up exactly 2 each time, and up perfectly at that doorway. I don't know. Don't know what to think. I'm suspicious. Not even sure of what. Right, whatever. Sometimes you just get a good lucky break. So, not one of those bad lucky breaks, but a good lucky break. So, next what I want to do, since we have the general path there. Oh, I also saw this. While I was over here, I saw this tunnel, and I forgot if I made it or not. So I was like, whatever. Just connect it up. So, you're kind of up here, so it's a secondary way up. So I don't know, I'll keep this. I'm not sure what'll be on the other end of it, but ultimately I want this to be the primary way up. So this is the old way up, and this is the new hotness. Okay, got it. So what I want to do now though is figure out the paths, and I'm gonna go to where they start, which is over here. Now. This path, all these lovely paths over here, they're used on the reg. On the reg. This one, not so much, I don't think. I don't think this one's used so much. So, we'll keep that in mind. But ultimately, I think the key here is to start simple. Just build what you know. And then kind of experiment from there. So I guess that's kind of my policy on almost everything I make. So I might as well do this on camera. Making a 3-wide path. It's gonna push out. What I'm thinking is it's gonna wind around this way, and then in between the pillar and the water wheel there. So maybe like from here, I'll start going at a diagonal. I don't want to cover up too much of that, though. I kind of like it. Maybe I'll do that. So that's a pretty long diagonal. It's going to come on in and scoot right in next to this pillar. I think that could look good. This part over here, I'm guessing I'm going to keep it 3 wide. I'll see how it interacts with the side of this. Maybe some refurbishments are going to go down here. Or at least some re-changements. So changes. I think that's the word I actually was looking for. Some changes will be happening. I don't know what re-changements are. So I'm going to give this a little bit of a floor support here. But this is also going to be 3 wide, I believe. Which means that this ladder is going to go. Which, you know, that... Okay, maybe you don't know. That's the plan, is to kind of get rid of this and make the actual entrance to the mine the one up there. So, all right, so this is the rough draft. The rough draft of the path design. I'll go in here. I'm guessing this is going bye-bye. And... Something like that. Next thing I want to look at is how it's existing. How is this actually happening? So stuff like supports would be something to start thinking about at this point. So I will. I'm thinking there'll have to be something. I'll go ahead and bring this all the way down. Some kind of pillar. Every just along this diagonal here. Think that could look good. I'll have little spaces in between. See on this side, maybe this, maybe. Yeah. All right, that's something. That's a something. I'm gonna do a little more now. Give it a little bit of depth, hopefully, in the downward direction, which is perfect for that word. And don't know, something like this. Some sort of a thing. A thingy. Oh, haha, I like that. I like when Minecraft helps you out. Like, I don't know what this should. Oh, okay, thank you. Thank you, Minecraft. I'm gonna go ahead and take away any blocks that are directly below the stairs. I think it's just there and there's. So, let's see, next. Think that back wall, looking at this back wall, should all be this. And actually, I think that's starting to look like something good. You know, I'll get this one too. So what's going down inside here? I think I'm gonna fill this in. So up to where the stairs are. So this will be too thick. Be way too thick. I kind of like this though. I'm gonna give this its room. I like that. Just in case a zombie wants to spawn in here, I'll put a little slab going on. I think this looks good for the most part. I might go ahead and do some of this. Just because dirt isn't the best way to hold up stone. At least I don't think it is. I don't know, I'm not one of those people that works with dirt and stone, so really I could have no idea what I'm talking about. I do want to keep some of this though. This looks kind of nice. Next, I have this mossy stone. This is the first time I think I've ever even used it. I'm just gonna pick a couple spots. I'm not gonna overdo it. Just, you know, a spot here and there where I think a little mossy stone could be hanging out. Ooh, this could be interesting. So it's sort of like it's make it look like it's climbing, probably. Don't know if I want to do too much of it outside of the water, though. And the reason why I'm going sparse is I know that you can get carried away in doing some of the stuff like this. But there's some spots where I think it would definitely make sense. Like if there's running water, totally. Totally. I also like not closing this up entirely because I like it looks like if you're like a young blood or something, you could be like, you know, play tag in here, I guess. I don't know. Whatever kids do. I don't know. I never was one. For this section, I'm actually kind of feeling a I don't know, I like to break things, you know, sometimes. So I'm feeling a busted out section would be nice right about here. So, I don't know, something like this. Just a little busted, you know. That's kind of a lot of busted, actually. But you know, well, we'll figure out how this goes. We'll just say it fell into disrepair. Maybe I'll bring this forward another one. So next up is this. This is just a one wide wall between the water and this side of the thing. The ladder leads down to the mine, this area which goes into the mine. I think that it'd do a lot better with this. And also, I think we could do something pretty interesting considering the fact that this is a collapsed part here to make this downstairs part look better. First thing I'm going to do is kind of fill in some stuff. What I would want to do probably is figure out a way to support these walls. I wouldn't mind doing it reminiscent of what's going on the other side, and maybe the other walls in the village. So, with those, I'm pretty sure that I was doing like three wide and having a pillar. So maybe every three, starting with like here, I could have some sort of a pillar design. All right, that's a start. Next, I'm gonna go up there. Let's get these upside down stairs going. And now I'm gonna fill in the wall, just one behind the stairs with cobble. There's like a support, and then stair block, and then a stair in front, which I'll probably use that. And then the sides, just at a different level, be stairs with blocks going down. And kind of like that. There we go. I replaced those with the brick stairs. That is a lot more feasible than just a flat wall. A little bit more interesting. And next, I'm going to just break out a chunk of it because I'll say why. It looks like the breakout section, the breakout year for the artist is here. So I could start here and just destroy all the stuff I did here. The reason why I did it in the first place is whenever I see ruins, I really like trying to reconstruct them to see if I can figure out what they were originally. And if you actually did have something that it was originally, then you can actually do that. So at this point, I can kind of wildly swing at and destroy things. Or not, you know. That actually probably looks good enough. And yeah, I could have just built that side and a little bit of this side. But it kind of. I like seeing the whole thing before I start mismantling it. And I don't know, I like this process. It feels like I'm also watching it erode. So next, what you could do if you want is, since it fell and stuff, you could put pieces of fellage down here. So how would I do that? Probably sprinkle it in. Nothing too crazy. Maybe a little crazy. Back here, definitely. You know what? I might actually take a cue from the grass in here. That actually might look good. I have grass blocks. What I could do is even have like patches where grass has kind of moved in. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. And you know what I could do is also, yeah, I have some bone meal. Any grass down there, I could just put some grass on. I can put grass on grass. Oh yeah, I forgot to do this tourney section here. Yeah, that could be fine. All right, I'm pretty happy with how that looks. I might tweak some things later. But I also like that you can see it from here, just this random path over here. You can look back and see some breakdown over there. Next, I want to look at the path itself. I think it's going to originally have had a railing here, and maybe it's not there anymore. Maybe it is. Maybe it could even go out this far, but over time, it's just only a couple pieces left. It could be something like that. Maybe this stuck out here. And stairs are good for little broken pieces like that. Corners are actually a lot of have a lot of potential for breaking bits. Here's a little trick though that I'd like to share is I like to have like little sort of like cracks that go along in a sort of logical manner. So, let's see if I can get one going here. If I can do. And stairs are great for this, because you can like do this, and wherever the notch is, just kind of have them line up, and it starts to make kind of a crack. I think that's kind of a cool thing to do with the cobblestone paths, because they tend to get monotonous. And if there's a broken spot like this, then yeah, definitely making a statement. Doesn't have to be perfectly connected either, you know. It's just it's implied. Things are implied. But I think that's a really cool that's a cool little touch. And it goes into the broken spot here, which I like. I'm liking that. Let's give it a little something here too. Now it really looks unstable. I really like that. I like that a lot. Just so you know. All right, so some path variation. Since this is an older path, I think it should have a little bit of grass growing into it. So I'll just dig a few spots that look, like that's probably good. Another good block to do this with is gravel. You just need to have another block underneath it. I could probably get away with that over here a little more. I don't really think the grass would look as good over here. I love how precarious this whole section here looks. Like there's a crack here, and there's a crack here, and it's not really connected on the side. Like it feels like this whole thing is gonna fall, like any moment. Just, I like that. I like it a lot. Yeah, I'm really not gonna make it too mysterious if I enjoy my handiwork. I hope that's not annoying. And now, one of the best steps that have ever been created ever. Just tons of bone meal. So that's that section. Now, it's this section. So while I'm building this path, I thought I'd take a little moment and kind of talk about what I'm going to be building in this series a little more. As you probably noticed, I already like making video game references quite a bit. I also like making realistic looking worlds and realistic feeling worlds. And on top of that, I've been pulling a lot of elements from fantasy stuff, like the worlds that you might see like in the Lord of the Rings or something. I guess to put it in simplest terms, what I'm trying to do is create a world in Minecraft that has elements of real life and video games and all the other fantasy stuff. But I want to make it all work. I think the closest term that comes to describing what I'm trying to do is magic realism, which is a very interesting thing. I guess a pretty good definition of magic realism actually would be depicting a world that is realistic and pretty much the same as our own, but yet contains supernatural elements. Like, people will be normal and react to everything like it's normal, but there'll be something that happens. Like, it's like if magic existed in the world, and everyone eventually they wouldn't be like, "Oh, whoa, this is cool," when they discovered it, but then they get used to it. It's kind of like how everyone has a TV or a cell phone. People don't walk around incredulous looking at their cell phone. It's just a part of, life. I actually think that Hayao Miyazaki films are pretty good, a good case study of this sort of phenomenon. And there's always people depicted realistically, but there's always some kind of strange element going on, or the whole thing could take place in the air, for instance. But everyone's okay with it, or it's just a part of their reality. Kiki's Delivery Service is actually a pretty good example, I think, because if there were witches or just people that could fly on brooms, then why not have them be delivery people? They'd be perfect for it. So like witches that are like a delivery service. It's kind of ingenious. But it's like really believable, and like, after a while you forget about the fact that, whoa, this, you just let yourself get taken up in the magic. There's also like the Final Fantasy series is like with materia and stuff. It's just something that happens in the world and everyone's aware of it. And it creates all this crazy stuff. Or like Final Fantasy X, where it actually has like religion and politics and even like pop culture, and also with like magic on top of it. Like, it's like world building is really kind of crazy, actually. Especially, like, you could just take all the rules and throw them out the window, but to make it mirror our own world, but just with like a tweak, you know, that's actually really fascinating to me. So that's actually on my mind quite a bit. The reason why I'm talking about this, it's on my mind quite a bit when I'm building here. And I do see this series as an excuse to try to build really crazy things, but not just crazy things, but try to make them realistic. Like, take this thing from over here and put it here, like the clock tower. You know, it's from Majora's Mask. Typically, it shows up in Clock Town, and it's all in that universe and stuff. But I like the fact that in this world that I've built here, it's like an old piece of machinery from the generations that came before, and it's sort of kind of magical because it's just, you know, it's kind of, you don't really know what it means. It works up there, but for the most part, the village, it doesn't seem to serve any real functions. Like, there's all the jobs, like the cows and the gardens, but it becomes like a thing that could have clues about it to tell about the past, and like the fact that it still works despite it being really old is also really cool. So there's like a mystery around that, and I found a way to have it live, or I guess exist in an area that, you know, it might seem weird to have this thing here, but I would, like, just the process of trying to justify it is cool. Also, the portals, another Zelda reference, are from Twilight Princess, and they're gonna be interesting to kind of work out. In that series in particular, it seemed that only the protagonist, Link, was really even perceptive enough to notice the portals. I don't think anyone even really pointed them out. So I could utilize that fact and just say that the portals are kind of obscure, so like the average person might not even see it. Like, literally, if they looked up, they might see it, but maybe they're just so busy in their lives that they just don't. Or it could just be something people take for granted, like the moon in the sky. Like, if the sky didn't have any moon in it, and all of a sudden it did, people would like freak out and be like, "What is that?" But it's always up there, so we've gotten pretty used to it. It's still kind of cool to look at, but you know, maybe it could be something like that where the people are aware of it. And that's a really fun process to me, actually. Is kind of figuring out, well, what would the inhabitants of this town think of this new thing that's here? Or like this thing that might have been here for a while. It's much more interesting to me than building a random thing, and then building another random thing, and then building another random thing. So yeah, magic realism. Now, since I mentioned video games, and since that is a part of this, and it also, this is a video game, I guess we could talk about that a little bit. Probably one of my favorite inspirations for things to put into the Minecraft worlds are really come from 3D platforming games. Stuff like Banjo-Kazooie, Zelda Ocarina of Time, and some of the stuff that came a little later, like Sly Cooper and the Pac-Man World series. There's some pretty interesting worlds that get created, and like they're you, especially if you can find yourself lost in them, and like platforming is almost built in. Like, as a possibility. And also with stuff like Redstone, you can make contraptions and stuff. Like, you can go like the Zelda dungeon route or any other type of thing like that, which I actually don't want to say too much about it because no spoilers. But yeah, those are a pretty big inspiration for the type of things I want to grab and try to put in the series. I guess there's also other things. Like, I can't help but get like huge inspiration from, I already mentioned, the Lord of the Rings movies, just because those worlds are huge and there's like big statues and stuff, and every region seems to have a backstory. And like the interesting thing about Tolkien books or his series is that like it'll have its own mythos, its own mythology that the characters themselves even reference as they're talking about other things. So it's like if you a real world equivalent would be like if someone was like, "By the beard of Zeus," or something. I guess no one would actually say that except for an Anchorman. But like the fact that you could call back to something, like if you say "Good God," that's referencing God. I guess that's pretty. But yeah, if you want to make a biblical reference, you're referencing the Bible. The point is, it's a part of our civilization's early beginnings that people can reference back to, which is gives depth to, I guess. Well, our world is a really good example, actually. Our world, it has a bunch of depth in it. There's history to it, and it's kind of cool to try to make that where there wasn't anything. And so when you take something like that and put it into a world you're trying to build, it's really interesting and fun to kind of try to make those memories or to try to make those stories and try to fit them into like a fake timeline or like a I try to treat it like this is a realistic place I'm creating. So that's why before I mentioned like having different depths of things back in time, like things that happened maybe like between now and 30 years ago, stuff that happened like 50 to 100 years ago, it's a little further in memory. Stuff that happened like 500 or 1,000 years ago, and stuff that happened like way before that. I think it's really cool to map that out and try to figure out, well, if this civilization happened then, made this cool thing, what did this next civilization probably do to it? Did they like graffiti all over it? Did they like praise it and like move it to a museum? Did later that museum collapse so the thing is there now? I find the possibilities there just so infinite and interesting. And on top of that, you can choose exactly what you put into the equation or into the story just by like what your own interests are. Like it's basically you're making a story, and more than that, you're making a world that has everything that you'd want in it. And that sounds awesome. Like that sounds really cool. Like that's where my main motivation to do this is really just to see if I can like make a world that fits all of these things that I said. And it's actually, I guess this is pretty dense to kind of lay it all out here, but I figure why not? Why not? But anyways, I hope that gives an idea of at least my thinking process about what I build in this world, at least as of now. It could change, and it's really kind of evolved to this point anyways. It didn't start here. So I guess this is also kind of chronicling, maybe I want to look back at these videos. And it is kind of interesting to look back at the old videos I make just to see what I'm thinking about and stuff. So this will be good for me too. But this is where I am, and I wanted to share it. And hopefully I've talked long enough to get some building done in the background. So with that being said, let's get back to the series. As is always good, let's take a walk on the creation that we just created. And get a nice look at what we done did. I really like how broken down and everything this looks and how it keeps with the theme from going in there. So we have like the grass sprinkled in, bits of this and that. I really like this. It looks good to me, you know? Just sometimes something looks good. And I just like that this is like a section that's broken here. And it's got the seams or the cracks. So something else I did though is I put in these bushes around and I tried to make this look like it has more of a way, a spot that the water's coming from. So I dug out some of that way up there. It's kind of mysterious where the origin of the water is, but it's not a nothing like it was before. I also did some stuff down here, including shoring up that entrance to the cave. I don't want that to be the entrance anymore. I'm done with that being the entrance. So what I did instead is kind of filled it in and put some shrubs and whatnot. So it's kind of like a sunken area that, could have been something. But I also kind of filled this in a little bit. So just to kind of add some stuff. Oh yeah, put grass kind of sprinkled along the sides. I didn't really go crazy because I didn't want to go crazy. Going crazy isn't a particular favorite of mine. But I also didn't really ha go, yeah. I didn't go too far behind here. Behind here. But I also like another reason why I like putting like overgrown stuff is I feel like that's a big feature of ruins and stuff, is that when the plants start to kind of take over, Thing is, there's not really much room for lushness in here. So, I don't know, I kind of like the claustrophobic feel though, of like stuff falling apart, still retaining some of its structure, but for the most part falling apart. For the most part, falling apart. And overall, I'm pretty happy with it. I guess the next part would be this, but I think I'm gonna save this for another video, because eventually this is gonna be the way down. And I'll have to figure out exactly how. You see, there's a couple ladders there, but I might want to dress this up to look fancy. Make it into maybe a parkour type thing with some definite intense consequences. But I guess that's another thing for another time. Maybe even next time, I don't know. I also like having this open area here just 'cause it feels like I don't know, it's cool to have like overhangs and different spots like that. I also knocked off some of that corner here so you can actually see it. Like this cliff right here came out further like that. But you can kind of see that there's more depth going on in there if you were kind of peeking around this corner. I know it's not very likely, but it's just every little bit of detail makes it seem that much more interesting to kind of explore. Like I would never want to skimp on any this even the smallest detail. Like it's just it makes it fun. It's fun. End of discussion. And that just about does it for the rest of the saga. What I meant to say was take care. Be kind to your fellow humans. Do the right thing, and right people, I guess. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.